God bless you, loved ones. Welcome to the Word with Chester. Today we'll continue study in the 6th chapter of the book of Numbers. God bless each of you. The Lord loves you, my dears, and so do I. I thank God for standing before you each day. It's a blessing to me to be able to stand here and teach the Word of God and obey the God of my salvation. I know that He spoke to me and told me to do this and share with you my devotion. And as a result, I am doing so, and many people are being blessed. Thank God for all of my LinkedIn followers. I thank God for all of you, my Facebook followers, Twitter followers, and I have many now that's listening to me from LinkedIn, and I want to thank God for you, for your endorsements, and the things that you do for me there, and recommending me and my work. I thank God for you, and I want you to know that I love you with the love of the Lord. I ask that you pray for us daily, that God will get the glory out of all that we do, and take us to higher heights, and do great and wondrous things through us. God is opening many doors, and in fact, doors open to the point to where you don't know which one to walk through. And I just want the leading of God to lead me in the right direction. I've never been the type of person that was hungry and that would do anything to get to the top and all of that kind of stuff. My focus is on doing the will of God and letting Him place me where He wants to place me. I realize it's not all about dollars and cents. It is about pleasing the Lord. If we please the Lord, we will be effective in what we do and reach those that He's assigned to our hand to reach. I thank God that I have that mindset. I don't worry if I don't be on the top tier and everyone can see me on television. So many sees me on the internet, and thank God for that entity that God made it so that we can exercise our gift in this manner. I look to go higher. I look to go to the next level, but you know I want God to be in that and not something that I'm doing myself, because you can place yourself in positions and regret it later. I don't want to be in that. That situation. I want God to place me where He can get the glory out of what I do. Well, in our last lesson from the 6th chapter of the book of Numbers, we read down to verse 15. Today we'll continue our reading in this chapter, chapter 6 of the book of Numbers. Now, if you remember reading, we were talking about those that were Nazarites and those that had taken a vow to be Nazarites or set themselves aside for the use or for God's use and let God be their all in all. God be their everything, even their joy. Now that's a place to be in when you can set yourself aside and not look for the carnal things for enjoyment as far as drinking and doing things that lean toward the flesh and things of that nature. When you set yourself aside to do the work of God, to do the will of God, and just live before Him in a holy manner, He blesses you and He gives you contentment. So that's what we were talking about, those that had made a vow to be Nazarites. And we went through a section where if someone accidentally broke one of the vows as far as what it took or accidentally hurt someone, accidentally killed someone, God made it so he could be restored and that vow of Nazareth would not be wasted. Well, here we read, if I would just read from verse 13 so you can get an understanding of where we are. And this is the law of the Nazarites. When the days of his separation are fulfilled, he shall be brought into the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, and he shall offer his offering unto the Lord, one he lamb of the first year without blemish unto the burnt offering, and one ewe lamb of the first year without blemish for a sin offering, and one ram lamb without blemish for a peace offering. Now this is what he had to offer. He made a vow to be a Nazarite and set himself apart to be a Nazarite, but something in life happened to where one of his Nazarite vows were broken. Instead of him just trashing the whole thing and say, look, I'm not going to be a Nazarite anymore and break his vow, God had made a way for him to be restored. And we just read in 13 and 14, now 15, and a basket of unleavened bread, cakes of fine flour mixed with oil, and wafers of unleavened bread anointed with oil, and their meal offerings and their drink offering. In other words, these offerings were brought, number one, for the atoning of his sin, and also for his restoration to his Nazarite vow. In verse 16, and the priest shall make them before the Lord, and shall offer his sin offering and his burnt offering. And he shall offer the ram for a sacrifice of peace offering unto the Lord. With the baskets of unleavened bread, the priest shall offer unto his meal offering and his drink offering. And the Nazarite shall shave the head of his separation at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, and shall take the hair of his head of his separation and put it in the fire which is under the sacrifice of the peace offering. What do you mean? Now, you remember the Nazarite vow. A Nazarite was not supposed to cut his hair. Am I correct? He was supposed to let his hair grow and not cut it. A Nazarite was not supposed to drink wine or strong drink. But listen, as we read now, after his sacrifice and the atonement for his sin was made, he shaved his head. He shaved his hair off and threw it in the fire. Well, his hair was burnt now. Well, let's read on verse 19. And the priest shall take the boiled shoulder of the ram and one unleavened cake of the basket and one unleavened wafer and shall put them upon the hand of the Nazarite after the hair of his separation is shaved. The hair of his separation is shaved. Well, that's the breaking of the vow because he promised to be a Nazarite. Well, the vow had been broken when someone died at his hand, or he accidentally touched a dead body or something of that nature. Well, you have to understand that vow was broken then. After his separation, he shaved his head. After this time, the time of atonement, that vow that he made, you got to understand, we got to start new. And sometimes you got to shave off all that old stuff so that you can start new. He shaved off his hair now. All of his hair, he was bald, and that hair thrown into the fire. Let's read verse 20. And the priest shall wave them, not his hair, we're talking about the shoulder now, of the sacrifice. And the priest shall wave them with the wave offering before the Lord. This is the holy for the priest. This is holy for the priest. I need to read it again. And the priest shall wave them for a wave offering before the Lord. This is holy for the priest with the wave beast and heave shoulder. And after that, the Nazarite may drink wine. Remember now, a condition of his vow was not to drink wine. Here, he drinks wine. Can you understand where God is separating the difference? When you made your vow unto the Lord, and then when that vow was some kind of way violated, and then through your own repentant heart, you went through everything by sacrificing the sin offering and sacrificing the wave offering. And all of that, you brought it back before the Lord. Now, verse 20 again, and the priest shall wave them for a wave offering before the Lord. This is holy for the priest. And the beast of the heave shoulder, and after the Nazarite may drink wine. This is the law of the Nazarite, who the vow of his offering unto the Lord for his separation. Beside that, that his hand shall get according to the vow which he vowed, and so he must do after the law of his separation. After he's been separated because of his vow, this he must do after his separation. Now let's read on in verse 22. I hope you're understanding what I'm saying to you today. In verse 22, and the Lord spoke unto Moses, saying, speak unto Aaron and to his son, saying, in this way ye shall bless the children of Israel, saying unto them. Now, we've changed context now. We've changed complete orders, talking from the Nazarite. He's now speaking to Moses, saying, speaking to Aaron and to his son, saying, all right, giving this order to the priest. In this way ye shall bless the children of Israel, saying unto them, the Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. And they shall put my name upon the children of Israel, and I will bless them. Well, get that picture. What God is telling the priest to bless his people with these words, and he would put his name and his peace upon the children of Israel. Well, God will bless you, my friends. He'll bless you, my dears. He will bless you. All you have to do is accept his ways and accept what he has for you. He's there, and he wants to bless you. His face will shine upon you. He will give you peace. He will give you joy even in this world. Well, I want you to know that I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. If you would like to contact me for any reason, you can write me at the Word with Chester Ministries, Post Office Box 200603, San Antonio, Texas 78220. You can also reach me at my website, www.poemsbychester.com. Well, I also want you to know that we have our music that's out for sale. We also have our book that's for sale. When you purchase my book or purchase my music, it will be a blessing to you, but you will be a blessing to this ministry. Remember, I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. God bless you.